each one thereof. I feel like running, skipping. Praise the Lord for what He has done for me. He has set my spirit free. I feel like running, skipping. For Rosie, I feel like running, skipping. Praise the Lord for what He has done for me. He has set my spirit free. I feel like running, skipping.
She has 2 minutes to get ready.
No, she is time. Thank you, Lord.
And now, Rosie. No, I'm only kidding.
Holy name, sing like never.
the Lord, oh my soul. My God.
Father God, we lift up your name and we glorify you. You are Abba Father. You are our Father who art in heaven. This evening, Lord, we humbly bow our heart in reverence to you. Hallelujah. We give you all glory and praise and honor, mighty God. We adore you. We reverence you. Hallelujah. We glorify your matchless name. Hallelujah. We come to you, God Almighty, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Oh, we give you thanks. Hallelujah. Oh, God Almighty, for allowing us to gather one more time in this fashion. Lord, we ask that your presence, mighty God, hallelujah, will sit upon us, mighty God. Let your Holy Spirit sit upon us this evening. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, hallelujah. For those who are feeling tired like myself and sleepy, I pray for strength. But most of all, Father God, we lift up Jamaica land we love to you. Hallelujah, Jesus, as we are bracing the storm. Oh, God, burial by name, I pray, God of the sea and the wind. Holy Spirit God, you control the wind, you control the sea. Hallelujah. I pray, Father God, that you will place your hand over the four corners of Jamaica. Ah, eternal Father, we ask you to guard our land, to guide our people, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, God Almighty, shift the storm, God, in a motion that of a satoria, sit upon Jamaica land, Mabondarabo Sakondoro Sataya. Oh, great God, hallelujah. You see the people, your people are crying out to you even now. Oh, God, because we know, Lord God Almighty, it's not going to be easy. And so we ask you for your mercy. We ask you for your mercy, mighty God. Extend your hand of mercy in the Caribbean right now. Oh, stretch out your hands over Jamaica, over the Caribbean, mighty God. In the name of Jesus, let no life be lost. Oh, great God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we are aware that St. Thomas is it even now. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit of God, strengthen your people. Hallelujah. You said you will never leave us and you will never forsake us. And so, Lord, we are aware that you are with us in the name of Jesus. And so we look to you. Hallelujah. And we believe and we give you thanks. Hallelujah. That even though the storm will pass, mighty God, you will keep your people in the shelter of your arms. Hallelujah. Have your way, mighty God. Have your way as we continue to seek you. Have your way, Father God. We give you thanks tonight. Whatever we fail of asking, hallelujah, fail not to grant it. Oh, God Almighty Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, God of your people tonight, mighty God. While some are rejoicing, some are sad. But Lord, just help them to realize that there is hope in you, Lord. We just give you thanks, Lord. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This evening, I just want to greet you in the mighty name of Jesus. It's nice to see some of the young people, bright faces, young faces. Hallelujah. We are looking at Revelation 5 as we have gone through 1 through to 5. And as I already tell you that Revelation is not an easy book. It brings conviction. Hallelujah. As you read the scripture and as you meditate upon what God is saying in the last days. Hallelujah. And John, as John was on the Isle of Patmos, and God spoke into him, say, write whatever you have seen and heard. Write so that you and I here today will understand. And so I ask you at this hour, even as we read through Revelation 5, you will meditate on God. Hallelujah. Just meditate on God. Hallelujah. Feel a shifting in the atmosphere. Just meditate on God and what he is saying. Because this is God's word, not my word, but it is God's word. Hallelujah. When I called my sister and my brothers this afternoon, and one of my brothers, he lives not far from where my house is in Jamaica. It's just walking distance, not far, like about 2 minutes, just around the road. And he said to me, he drove to pick up my stepfather, which is his dad, and my sister, and he take them to his house. And I know that if in case the worst, I know that they will be safe. And they could even go by my house, because I have 6 brothers in Jamaica, and 1 sister. My stepfather, my aunts and uncles. But I continue to pray for them, and not only them, but Jamaicans and a whole. Our country is flat and it's surrounded by the Caribbean Seas. The good thing is that we have mountains. We have a lot of mountains, and that kind of keep the wind off. But I'm sure that we will get the rain. But God is still God. And so we look at Revelation 5, and we will go through it. And it read, "And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within, and on the backside sealed with 7 seals. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, 'Who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seal thereof?' And no man in heaven, nor in earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. And I wept much," that's John speaking, "because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. And one of the elders said unto me, 'Weep not, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, had prevailed to open the book and to loose the 7 seals thereof. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne of the 4 beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb as it has been slain, having 7 horns and 7 eyes, which are the 7 spirits of God sent forth into all the earth. And he came and took the book out of the right hand of him that sat upon the throne. And when he had taken the book, the 4 beasts and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, having every one of them harps and golden vials full of orders which are the prayers of the saints. And they sung a new song, saying, 'Thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seal thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by thy blood out of every kindreds and tongues and people and nation, and has made us unto our God kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth. And I beheld, and I heard the voice of many angels round above the throne and the beasts and the elders, and the number of them was 10,000 times 10,000s and thousands of thousands, hallelujah, saying with a loud voice, 'Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessings. And every creature which is in heaven and in earth and under the earth, and such as are in the sea, and all that are in them, heard I saying, blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him that sit upon the throne, hallelujah, and upon and unto the Lamb forever and ever. And the four beasts said, Amen. And the 24 elders fell down and worshiped him that live forever and ever. The word of the Lord. Hallelujah. May God's word bring healing to our soul and blessings. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Blessings and honor, glory and power be unto the Ancient of Days. From every nation, all our creation, be unto the Ancient of Days. Every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. In worship you'll be exalted, O God, and your kingdom shall not pass away, O Ancient of Days. Hallelujah. He's the Ancient of Days. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Here John, according to Revelation 5, is saying that as he was in the Isle of Patmos and God, Spirit, he was in the Spirit and God was ministering to him and talking to him. And he was writing. And in the first verse, he said, I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book. Hallelujah. A book was in his hand. Hallelujah. Glory to God. A book. My brothers and sisters, we understand from kids growing up, my mother always said, if you behave bad, your God is going to erase your name. And I'm like, erase my name from when? From where? Hallelujah. And she said, God have a big book. God have a big book. And he wrote everybody's name in that book. And when you misbehave, he's going to erase your name out of the book. And as kids, you know, we fear. And so we would try to do everything right because we don't want our name to be erased out of the book. And my mother would beat us and said, God is going to erase your name. You're too stubborn. You must hear. You must have manners and all of that. But you know, growing up, I mean, we understand that there is a book, and there is another book, and another book. Hallelujah. And when he shall return, he's going to open those books. And I always, when I'm in my prayer time, I would ask myself, is my name written there? But God in his word said, he have engraved us in the palm of his hands. Once you acknowledge him as Lord and Savior. And you know, when you read the word, and you, if you believe the word, whatever is happening in your life, as long as you believe the word. And that's why those great men of old, like David and all of that, because they know the word and they know the Lord and they believe in the Lord, they trust God so much. But we, why are we so doubtful? Why are we so fearful? God said he has engraved us once you acknowledge him. I know that there's an M in the middle of my hand. There's no doubt because it is so plain. And that's how God has engraved each and every one of us in his hand. He keeps us so close to him because the minute he opened his hands, hallelujah, he saw Melissa Jenkins. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Once he opened his hands, hallelujah, he sees your name engraved. Hallelujah. So we need not to fear. Hallelujah. Because he engraved us. We are always close to him. He could have written our name on the bottom of his feet. He did not. He placed it in his hands. The very palm of his hand. So scripture tells us he will never leave us. And he will never forsake us. I encourage us when you feel down, when you feel depressed, when you feel lonely, when you feel as if nobody cares. There's a God that cares because your name is in his hands. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, the Bible talks about seven seal in verse 1. The seventh seal represents the first in a series of judgment to come on the earth that was also included seven trumpets, hallelujah, and seven bowls among metaphorically depictions of God's wrath. The scroll is like a title deed to the earth. Hallelujah. It was during the course of this week. I don't know why I tried to find my title for my house in Jamaica. Hallelujah. It's good to have a title. And so I may not have a vehicle yet with a title, but I have a house. And so I pull out my title and I start to read what was on it, the person name that first owned the house. And then when I saw my name, I said, thank you, Jesus. I feel happy. I feel happy. And I was like, thank you, Jesus. And so, brothers and sisters, the seal is like a title. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. The scroll, not the seal, the scroll is like a title deeds in the earth. And so we all aware of what scroll is, right? Yeah. We have our title because it's a big paper, you know. Mm-hmm. And what happened? Because it has gone through so many hands. They tape it. They had to tape it together. Nice, you know, it looks good. It's big about this, yes. And so they fold it so neat. But it's just neat. It just looks nice. Maybe true my name is on it. Oh, God, I love you, Jesus. You see me laughing? You guys don't understand. I didn't have it. And I own a house, I have a title. Young people, stay with God. I say I didn't have it. Every time I open up my fridge, it was just water. Nothing. Hallelujah. I could have gone out there and do things to get food. But I refuse. I'd rather to suffer and be with God. Hallelujah. So when I see those things that I have achieved, it's not me, it's God just put people in my life to bless me. Hallelujah. I remember one lady looked at me and said, what keep you? And I said to her, I'm not better than you. But each time when I want to sin, I said I cannot hide from God. I can hide from everybody else. But I know He's right there with me, so I can't do it. Mm-hmm. I'm not perfect. But because I know that God is there and He's seeing me, I don't hide from man. And I can't hide from God. And that is more important. You have to have a marker in your life. You have to set a marker, a standard in your life. If I do this, God is going to see me. Pastor Perry don't see and know who I am or what I am doing. Because
he doesn't want to.
But God see. God see, and He's the one who's going to judge us when He returns.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, if you're going through hard times, it's not easy. But understand He's taking you through it. Because when you go through it, you feel good. You feel good. Hallelujah. That's why I feel, Hallelujah. You feel good. You feel like a giant. You feel like you have accomplished something. Just like when you're getting an exam and you don't cheat. Hallelujah. You don't cheat in the exam. You know you study and you write what you remember. And when you get that 80% or even 60, because 60 would have been the pass mark, you feel so good. You have accomplished something. You pass. Just like when I was taking the learner's permit, and I was so afraid. And one day I heard the voice of God said, "Do the exam now." And I become so nervous. I'm like, "God, I'm not ready. Do the exam now." And when I was there with my hand nervous, then the Holy Spirit said, "I am with you." When I see congratulations, what sweet song. Oh my God. Brothers and sisters, to stay in Jesus, it's sweet. It is so sweet to trust in Jesus. And so, the scroll is like a title deed to the earth. It depicts God's ownership of all creation and right to all accountable those who use it and thus dishonor Him. Those who muse it and thus dishonor Him. Through judgment administrated by Jesus, God once again will lay claim to this creation which was plunged into sin by Adam. Mm-hmm. According to Genesis 3. And we understand what Adam did, although he tried to blame Eve, but he was the man. I encourage you men to be the man. Hallelujah. Don't let any woman seduce you. You are the man. You are the leader. And so God placed Adam in the garden as a leader. Hallelujah. When God looked and He understand and realized that everybody had a partner, He said, "No, it's not good for man to be alone." And so He created Eve. But being the weaker vessel, Eve, hallelujah, listen to the devil. The devil, the Bible said, the devil beguiled Eve, and Eve beguile Adam. And so Adam did not stand. Adam give away his authority to the devil. And because of that, sin enter the world. And it comes all the way down. And we would just blame Adam and said, "Adam, why did you have to do that?" But you know, we would have done the same thing, and we continue to do it on a daily basis. And so sin enter the world. Hallelujah. According to verse 2 through to 4, let me refresh your memory. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seal thereof?" And no man in heaven or in earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. And I wept much because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. In response to the question of a mighty angel, who is worthy to open the scroll and break its seal? No one in heaven or on earth or under the earth is found worthy. In fact, no one is worthy even to look at the Lord's plan for the worldwide judgment, much less administer his prompting. This, because of this, it prompted John to weep. Because John realized that no man was worthy, it caused him to weep. Because you see, when you sit and you begin to meditate, and you said, "But God, you died for me. Am I really worthy? And I'm not worthy of your blessings. I'm not worthy of what you are giving to me. I'm not worthy, God." And so, because man is emotional, I'm a very emotional person, so my tears would come so quick. And, you know, I went to the eye doctor, what do you call it?
Optometrist.
I went in INS, the vision thing. And when I asked the doctor what was wrong with my eye, what caused the light to keep flashing and my eyes to run water, and she said, "It's no problem, your eye muscles are strong, your eye is good," and she started to show me everything, my big eye in the thing, and I'm looking at these veins and all that, and I'm like, "God, you're so awesome." And she showed me everything on the picture. I'm like, "God, you're awesome." And she said, "You need to buy the artificial tears so that would prevent your eye, because your eye is dry." And that made me laugh. I said, "My eye is dry and I'm ever crying. I don't need no artificial tears. I'm always crying." Because right now I stand here, I'm crying. I don't need no artificial tears. Hallelujah. So I don't understand that part. I know when she zoomed in my left eye, I saw this little black thing. And she said, "The eye nerves is good." I saw a little black thing, but it's nothing. It's nothing for you to worry about. That's the second person, that doctor, that told me that. But I don't know what that little black thing is, but maybe it's the Holy Spirit. Oh, God. Yes, my brothers and sisters. And so it pushed John to weep when he looked. And he said, "No, man, nobody not worthy. None of us. Nobody is not worthy to open the book." And he began to weep. His emotions, you know, get the better part of him. John wasn't thinking that, "Come on, Jesus is here. He did it." So John is just like the movie that came out long time ago. What's that movie? Jesus. It's a Huh?
Passion of the Christ.
The?
Passion of the Christ.
Yes. And when you watch that movie, you wonder why God go through all of that for us. Have you ever think about it?
Yeah. It's brutal.
Why God go through all of that? So that would bring tears to your eyes. Mm. And that's the scenery that John, hallelujah, was depicting as he wept, because he said, no one is worthy. But as the commentator wants to say, indeed, no one is worthy, because no one knows, or no one can look in God's book. We are not worthy enough to know anything. You understand? We are not worthy. Hallelujah. And so John wept, and that's why we continue to weep when we feel the presence of God and how good we feel. It brings tears to our eyes. When God protects us from all sorts of things, it brings tears to our eyes. When we live through a day and we realize that we had gone through yesterday and we are in today, and so many life has been lost, but our life is spared. Hallelujah, it brings tears to our eyes. What did I do? That person didn't do. Why God loved me so much? You understand? And that's why the Bible said we must not boast about whatever we achieve, but boast in Jesus. Hallelujah. As John began to weep, one of the angels comforted John, telling him not to cry, because Jesus, the lion from the tribe of Judah, the root of David, is worthy to open the scroll and administer the judgment of its seal. This scene reflects the fact that sinful people, even when they are redeemed, fall short of the qualification necessary for one who could judge the earth. But Christ, by virtue of his full divinity, sinless humanity, and anointing debt, is qualified, and the God and God the Father has granted judging authority to the Son. Let us read John 5, verse 22 through to 27. Somebody read that for me, please. John 5, 22, 27.
For the Father judgeth no man, but hath committed all judgment unto the Son, that all men should honor the Son, even as they honor the Father. He that honoreth not the Son, honoreth not the Father, which hath sent him. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that hears my word and believes on him that sent me hath everlasting life, and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is come, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear shall live. For as the Father hath life in himself, so hath he given to the Son to have life in himself, and hath given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of Man.
Amen. And so God is saying that he has given judgment to his Son. Hallelujah. The Father is not going to judge you, but all judgment, hallelujah, is given to his Son. And so Jesus, hallelujah, have authority, hallelujah, to judge. Jesus died to redeem humanity at his first coming. He will judge in order to redeem the entire creation at his second coming. Hallelujah. So Jesus Christ died to redeem us from sin. Hallelujah, when he first come to this earth as a babe. Hallelujah. The second time when he's coming, he's not coming to redeem, but to judge every man accordingly. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is coming back as a judge. Hallelujah. He have the authority to judge. And so when any man or anyone try to judge you, tell them, you cannot judge me. Jesus Christ is my judge. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is no man on the face of this earth that know you like Jesus. Hallelujah. There is no man on the face of this earth that own you. Jesus Christ own you. Hallelujah. He shed his blood. He bought you with a price. Hallelujah. He bought you with his blood. His price. Blood. Hallelujah. So you are Boshandarabasatoria. You were bought with a price. Hallelujah. And that price, hallelujah, is the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Let us run down to verse 6. Hallelujah. Verse 6 said, and I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne, and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb, as it has been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God, sent forth into all the earth. And he came and took the book out of the right hand of him that sat upon the throne. Hallelujah. The depiction of Christ like a slaughtered lamb. Hallelujah. Contrast with the lion metaphor of according to verse 5 and 5. Yet this is not a contradiction. Jesus is real, regal, like a lion. Hallelujah. Jesus is like a lion. He roar like a lion. Hallelujah. You serve an awesome God. Hallelujah. That's why as children of God, we are not wimped. We are not wimp. We are eager. Hallelujah. We are strong. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If Jesus, our Father, is like a lion. Hallelujah. He's the king of the jungle. He's the king of our life. Understand. Hallelujah. That although he looks like a lamb, yet this is not a contradiction. Understand, Jesus is regal like a lion. He was slain like a sacrificial lamb to atone for the sins of the world, the whole world. Let's read Isaiah 53 and verse 7. Isaiah 53 and verse 7.
He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he opens not his mouth.
Hallelujah. And so, as he was brought before her shear like a sheep, he did not open his mouth. You ever wonder why Jesus didn't open his mouth?
For one thing, it's not good to put your pearls before swine. And that particular King Herod was not a good person. Let's just put it that way. He was the lowest of low. And he wouldn't have listened anyway. Sometimes you find people that you've tried, and then eventually you just say to yourself, you know what? They don't want to hear. and they don't want to listen.
They don't want to listen. Mm-hmm. They're not interested.
So why say?
Why say anything?
Mm-hmm. They don't understand the truth.
I think also that it's the same mouth that spoke the world into existence. Mm-hmm. So if he opened his mouth and just uttered one word, it would have changed.
Destroy everything. You see, because he is God. The Bible said he was fully God, fully man. And he didn't open his mouth because of you and I.
So scripture can be fulfilled.
So the scripture can be, because he was innocent. And when you know that you're innocent, you don't have to explain nothing to anybody. Let them waste their time and talk. Silence is when somebody cussing you out and you remain silent, you know that person feels shame. Shame. I remember once I went to a retreat. Like a camp? Yeah. I went to a retreat, Christian retreat. But it was for the executive member of the church that I go to. And at that time, I was the young lady director. I was in charge of the young lady ministry because I was pretty young. And I had a best friend. But she was, when she was a sinner or an unsaved, I ministered to her. And I remember when I ministered to her, she said, I admire you as a child of God. But if I should become a Christian, I don't want to suffer like you. And I said to her, you don't have to go through what I go through. God put us through different things. And I explained to her, and she accepted the Lord. She was my best friend, but she was in the world. And I always talk to myself, and I said, why a child of God, best friend, is an unsaved? It can't work, right, Brother Tom? And so I witnessed her, and she gave her life to the Lord. But this girl that I love so much, she come into the church, and she began to keep friends with people. You know, the devil will use people to pull you apart. Because she know if she stick to me, all she would do is just pray, seek God more, and... And that's not what the devil wants. Because this girl used to fight for me. Because I don't fight. I don't fight. And so she would fight for me. She would defend me. You know, and I was like a mother to her daughter. And so she come into the church and all of that. And the Lord begins to show me things and show me a friend. Because when you're serving God, you don't have to ask anybody who is saying things about you. The Holy Spirit will show you. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, my best friend, no. And she would come and she would say, she hear all sorts of something. And she know me quite well that I pray a lot. And so we went to the meeting, but she wasn't supposed to be there because she wasn't a part of the executive. But however, she was present because apparently she drove somebody there. And the devil is cunning. And so we were in the meeting and she came in. And I was like, what you doing here? And she looked at me with a look that I've never seen before. And I'm like, my spirit feels troubled. Something doesn't add up. Anyway, she began to talk. She opened up her mouth and she began to say a lot of negative things in the meeting about me. And I didn't say a word. I want to cry. but the tears couldn't come. My pastor wife looked at me and she said, Sister Rosie, pray. I need you to pray. And it's the first time somebody ever asked me to pray, and I said no. And my pastor wife looked at me and said, why you said? I said, I can't pray. This atmosphere is not ready for prayer, and I cannot pray. Something needs to be done. There's a lot of things that has just been spoken about me through my best friend. And I don't like it. And I cannot pray. And she sat there and she looked at me. And as the president and the leader, she said, we need to talk. Everybody started to talk and who wanted to talk. And this lady stood up in the meeting. And she said, I'm not perfect. Sister Rosie is not perfect. But everything that just been said about her, I don't believe it. She said, I don't know her like you do. But I don't believe it. And I sat there and the tears want to come and the Lord said, oh no. And no prayer was said and everybody began to talk and my pastor wife looked at me and said, are you okay? I said, I'm okay. And she said, talk to her. But I couldn't talk. And so she break us up into groups. And only one thing I want to say to my friend, why did you do that? Why did you embarrass me like that? And she said, I didn't embarrass you, I embarrassed myself. And right through the camp, I just began to cry, asking the Lord why. And the lady that spoke, she was the one who drove me home. And when I get out of the car at my house and the tears start to come, she looked at me under the anointing power of God. And she said, you were brought as a lamb to the slaughter. And you opened not your mouth. As of this day, the Lord said he's going to bless you. And take you to places you have never dreamed of going and be. Brothers and sisters, it was 3 months after that, I found myself in America. Remain humble. You're going to be judged. You're going to be ridiculed by your friend, by families. Hallelujah. Stay strong. Remain humble. Because God is going to take you through with his mighty hand. Hallelujah. And so, my brothers and sisters, the depiction of Christ as a slaughtered lamb contrasts with the lion metaphor of, yet this is not a contradiction. Jesus is regal like a lion. He was slain like a sacrificial lamb to atone for the sins of the world. The old world. The repetition of the number 7, 7 horns, as we all aware that 7 is completion, 7 horns, 7 eyes, 7 spirits of God signify the completeness of Christ's anointed work. Because he fulfilled all righteousness. Let us look at Matthew, and I think I have it in Matthew 3 and verse 15. Yes. And Jesus answering said unto him, suffer it to be so now, for thus it becometh us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he suffered himself. Hallelujah. I want to let us understand that Jesus Christ, he is qualified to bring judgment on the earth. Hallelujah. And that is what going to happen. I am assuring you, Jesus Christ is qualified. Hallelujah. And he's going to bring judgment to the sinful earth. Hallelujah. He shed his blood. Hallelujah. For humanity, but humanity, hallelujah, has turned away. Hallelujah. Humanity, hallelujah, has betrayed the blood of Jesus. And so Jesus Christ is coming back to judge every man. Hallelujah. He is qualified to bring judgment on the earth. Hence, he went and took the scroll out of the right hand of the one seated on the throne. Hallelujah. It's because of his blood, hallelujah, that was shed, made him qualify enough, hallelujah, to break the seal and take the scroll. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, I encourage us to continue to pray and to seek the Lord, because when we pray, hallelujah, God will answer. The Bible said in verse 8, hallelujah, 9, hallelujah, the prayer of the saints. It talk about the prayer of the saints. Hallelujah. Prayers of God's people for vindication are pictured as incense raising from golden bowls. Hallelujah. And so our prayer is stored up in heaven. Hallelujah. Our prayer is stored up. Hallelujah. In heavens. Listen, two implications of the metaphor are that prayer truly reaches God and pleases him. As the living creatures and 24 elders fall down before Christ, they cite his redemption of the diverse population as part of the reason he is worthy to judge the world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The mention of redeemed people in heaven being from every tribes and language and people and nation. Understand that every tribe, black, everybody, white, yellow, pink, every tribe, hallelujah, every nation, hallelujah, portray, rather you be the ethnic, logistic, natural, normal diversity that will be present in eternity. All sorts of people from every nation and every tribe will be present in heaven. Don't let anybody tell you it's only white people, it's only black, it's only colored people. Every person. Hallelujah. The Bible said of every nation, of every diversity, that will be present in eternity. This means that different and diversity are no problem, are not problem to be solved, but were part of God's plan. From the very beginning, God had delighted in variety and beauty of his creation. You know, we serve an awesome God. There is no designer like God. Amen. Hallelujah. You look at our summer is approaching, and when you drive by, you see how beautiful those flowers are, blue, yeah. Pink, white, you know, you name it. Some I love red. Yeah, red make me weak. And so I was passing on the red rose blooming. I stand under it here with my phone, and I began to take pictures with myself. I'm crazy when it comes to red. I love red. I don't know why, but I love red. My children used to, "Mommy, that stupid color, what happened to you?" It's the most beautiful color to me. If you buy me something, all when it's ugly, as long as it's red, I don't care. That's my color. And so God just beautified the earth. I used to work in New Hampshire, and when I drove past the hills and see oh my God, the beauty. So God is a designer. He's the best designer. And so he a variety and beauty of his creation. Here is this perfect, complete worship service. Around the throne, we can see clearly red. Ah, that's the first color I call red, yellow, black, white are all precious in God's sight. You know this song, right? Red or yellow, black or white, they are precious in His sight. Jesus, the children of the world. I love my young people, they are so attentive. Yeah, listen, young Todd, minister young Todd. Yeah. Hallelujah. And so, all people are precious in God's sight. And this diversity community of saints is unfiltered in their worship of the Lamb. Christian unity does not mean uniformity, but a sheer of focus and worship of Christ. Hallelujah. When we as brothers and sisters and children of God assemble together and begun to sing and worship, oh, the sweet aroma that fills the atmosphere, that caused Sister Rosie to turn aside and weep and cry. Hallelujah. Although her face may set away, but she's worshiping God. I'm happy inside. Hallelujah. I love when we come together as a body and worship the Creator. Hallelujah. Because He is worthy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When we focus and we come together in unity and begin to worship, that's where healing take place. That's where miracle take place. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, verse 10 of chapter 5, that's where we reach. Verse 10 says, "And has made us unto our God kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth." Where? Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are kings and priests. You are royalty. The Bible said we are royal priesthood. We are holy nation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I need a car and I must get a car. And guess what? I stood at the bus stop and I saw these cars just passing. And yesterday I saw a red Tesla. Oh, it's so cute. Yeah, but dear God, I want to see the person. I look and I saw the lady. Yeah, but God, you're so good. Why are you showing me Tesla? And it's just cute. You ever see it? Yeah. Ah, don't it cute? Shape good, nice, cute. God give his children the best, right? Yes. I didn't even know it was a Tesla, but when I see the T, I said, "What a T that's." Because I don't know a car.
10,000, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000, 100,000. I think there are 100,000.
What?
I'm sorry.
That's a lot of money.
He was testing
you. Why should buy one? He was testing you.
I mean, I stood and I look at the car.
Almost as much as your house.
And then I saw a white one drove up right at my foot. And I'm like, I like your car. It's a lady. She came out. And I said, I like your car. And she said, how far are you going? No, she said, where do you live? I said, just live up the road. But she thought I was going home, but I was going to. She said, come, let me give you a ride. I said, no, I'm going to work. Because then I'd get a ride in the Tesla. But I want the red. Yeah, I need a car. I'm going to pay down on a car. Yeah, so if you know about any car that is reasonable and in good condition, and because I don't know nothing about it. All I know is to sit around there and just drive it. So I don't want no car that will, if I start it, it break down out there, okay? And it have to be red. Because if it's not red, I'm going to trade it in. Or maybe God want me to finance one, right?
Yeah.
Anything will work right now because it's a need and not a want. I'm tired of walking. Hey, I'm a child of a king. Mm-hmm. I'm tired of walking. Okay, so the destiny of every believer is to reign on the earth as priests to our God. This will occur in the millennium kingdom and in the new heavens and the new earth of the millennium. John wrote specifically, blessed and holy is the one who share in the first resurrection, salvation, the second death, eternal judgment, has no power over them, but they will be priests of God and of Christ, and they will reign with him for 1,000 years, Revelation 20 and verse 6. Previously, John recorded Christ's promise of authority over the nation for the one who conquers. Verse 2:26 of Revelation. You were redeemed to reign. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, the chapter culminates in a magnificent scene of worship involving many angels. What the Bible said, it said thousands and tens of thousands and thousands. Many angels, the living creatures and the elders, the total number of worshipers reaches countless thousands plus thousands of thousands. Hallelujah. Just picture it. Countless thousands. What an awesome God. Plus thousands of thousands. Their song repeat the word worthy. Hallelujah. For the fifth time since chapter 4:11, over which sprang its first, was applied to God the Father, and then twice to the Son, emphasizing that co-equal, emphasizing their co-equality and divinity. So we understand that the Father and the Son is co-equal. Hallelujah. They are co-equal and divinity. The first two persons of the Trinity our worship together, when every creature in heaven and on earth, under the earth and the sea and everything in them, praises the one who seated on the throne and the Lamb forever. The worship is affirmed by the four living creatures, hallelujah, with the elders joining as well, as when people clamor to see and cheer a celebrity. Have you ever seen when people, the car would open up and they would stand in the car and driving by and people are cheering and clamoring all over. Hallelujah. Can you picture in your mind the coming of our Lord and every creature with the elder joining as well and worshiping God? Worship, hallelujah. Worship is required to ignite the heart of God's people to Him. When human and angels behold Christ, the Lion and the Lamb, hallelujah, they cannot help but fall down and worship. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When angels and human come together to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. He is worthy of our praise. To Him be all glory and honor. Hallelujah. Thousands upon thousands worshiping, bowing down to the King, the Savior of the world. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's holy. Hallelujah. Who is like unto Him? Jesus Christ is worthy of our praise. Is worthy of our worship. Hallelujah. He deserves our all, not just a part. And He wants us to worship Him with our whole being. Hallelujah. Not just a part. Not one foot in or one foot out. Hallelujah. He deserves, hallelujah, our all. Authentic praise and worship. Hallelujah. And so as we come together to worship, let us understand that we are not worshiping man, but we are worshiping the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, the bright morning stars. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let your worship be authentic. We worship you, Lord. We worship you. Hallelujah. We adore you. We lift you up. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Can you imagine in your little mind how it's going to be when thousands upon thousands upon 10,000s upon thousands lifting their hands and bowing their knee, saying, holy, worthy, not crucifying, crucifying, but holy and worthy. Heaven blessed us as we continue to seek the mind of Christ and to give Him authentic praise and worship. Thank you for being here and for listening to the word of God. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
No, put it back on. I told we get the two done before. Number 11 on, please.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father God, come, come, come. Come, you young people.
Go ahead, young people.
Hallelujah.
Oh, here I am.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We are young at heart. Yeah. Hallelujah.
We're all that age.
Father God, here are your soldiers. Yes, young in body, in mind, in soul, and spirit. Hallelujah. The devil don't deserve them, and the devil will not get them. They are your children. You know the reason they're here this evening. I pray even now that you will let my hands be your hands. Hallelujah. La bondorobo sakuri andarabasataya. Cover the boshanda. Libondo rabako siendele. Cover them under your blood. In the name of Jesus Christ. Protect them, Lord, from every dangers. Hallelujah. That will try to come their way. Back them up on every side. Let the spirit of excellency be upon them, mighty God. Strengthen them, provide for them, bless them in every area of their life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Holy Spirit of God, anoint them. Anoint their tongues. Let them be labokondo rabakosiendelebekondo. In the name of Jesus Christ, we come against principalities and powers. We come against spiritual wickednesses in high places. In the mighty name of Jesus, we confuse and confound every plot and plan of the enemy that would want to destroy their destiny. We come against every destiny blockers in their life. We call for destiny blesser in these kids' life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Shine down upon them, Lord. Bless their going out and their coming in. In the name of Jesus Christ, I commend them to you, to the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, we're going to send you a song. We might do one of these others that are already here. Oh,
The greatest
love of all is mine. Since you laid down your life, the greatest sacrifice. Just as I am, empty-handed but alive in your majesty, majesty, majesty. Forever I am changed, forever I am changed by your love, in the presence of your majesty, majesty. Empty-handed, but alive in your heart, majesty, majesty, majesty. Forever I am changed by your love, in the presence of your majesty.
Thank you that we could be with you this evening, that we could partake from your word, that we could grow in you. Lord, we're expecting great and wonderful things to happen within our lifetime to see your glory on this earth. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful rest of your week. Till Friday at 6 o'clock when we have Shabbat worship and prayer.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Happy 4th of July.
Oh, yeah.